Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. Mailchimp have just released their Preferences Center, and this is something certainly that my clients have asked for a lot in the past, so it's a very welcome addition. The Preferences Center is where subscribers can tell you, as the account holder or as the sender, tell you what information they want to receive. Let's go across to Mailchimp and I'll explain it a little bit more. Right, I'm in Mailchimp. Now, just to be clear about how this works. So what happens, the Preference Center is, and I'm just going to go to edit the design of an email campaign. The Preference Center appears, and we'll just wait for this to load. It appears when someone clicks Update Profile at the bottom of an email campaign. So for example, in the very footer, and it might be a little bit small for you, and I'll just click on the footer. But in the footer where it says here, update your preferences. So when, for example, you send me an email, I click update your preferences, I'll be taken to the Preferences Center, which I'll describe in a few seconds. Now, in the past, you were taken to a form. It's changed very slightly. But it remains that if someone clicks unsubscribe, they're immediately marked as unsubscribed in your audience and you cannot send to them again. So what I can imagine is that what many people will do is sort of highlight the update your preferences and then have slightly smaller unsubscribe, something like that, because you will still have to have your unsubscribe link. Another thing that's changed is that people can now unsubscribe from all emails in the Preference Center too. Okay, but it'll make sense in a second. So let's just go across to our audience. The Preferences Center is handled within audiences or in your audience. So let me click on audience to the left-hand side of the screen. And you'll notice we can now see Preferences Center to the left-hand side there. I'll click on Preferences Center. So what we do is we build our Preferences Center. I'll start to build it and then I'll just show you how we can sort of make some changes in what we need to do. It'll make more sense. So I'm going to click start building, and remember this will show what we're building now. The Preferences Center will show when a person clicks the update the profile link at the bottom of an email. So Mailchimp provide certain defaults here, and as you can see at the bottom, sorry, I've just got something in the way here, my microphone in the way, but if I click on the little color button, I can change the colors, for example, and I'll just take it back to what it was. I can even change the sort of default text if you want to. Let's go to Anton, for example. I can add an image and so on. So I'll get back onto this in a second, but here are my form fields. So these are the fields that are in my audience. Okay, so I probably typically don't want to show all these fields to the person. So we can hide these fields from showing for the person when they click update your preferences, such as VIP and so on. And you'll notice at the bottom that the person can make changes and then they can update their preferences, or they can even from this update form, this profile update form, the Preferences Center, they can unsubscribe from all emails too. Okay, but so what I'm going to show you in a short while is how we can hide some of these fields. Another thing to know is that we can use groups in our Preferences Center. A group, for those of us that know, or if you don't know, in Mailchimp, a group is a way we can get people to determine or to select in their own way what they belong to, I guess, or we can use them in segments and so on. Makes sense in a second. But for now, if I want to, I could replace, and I would. I would replace the logo up the top. I can even, you know, replace the wording and so on. But let's not carry on for now. We'll come back to this. I'm going to click finish later. And I'm just going to demonstrate. So in my audience, if I now view my audience, so I'm going to click on my number of contacts. And what you'll notice is those fields, VIP, etc., all appeared. You can see them in my audience. The way I can hide these from showing in the Preference Center, so they'll still appear for you, but not for your subscriber, for example, is I can quite simply go into Settings, audience fields and merge tags. So settings, audience fields and merge tags. And then if you don't want specific fields to show on on that form that people will see, you can just uncheck here, for example. So let me just show you. I'll just quickly uncheck all of these and click Save Changes. So again, I went into settings, audience fields and merge tags. I unchecked what I don't want to be visible. And I clicked Save Changes. You can also make fields required if you so wish. Okay, so at the moment, the email address and first name field are the only fields that will appear in the preferences center on the form people will see. But let me add groups so people can select what type of communication. So let's do this. Let's say I hold MailChimp classes. So let's say, for example, I want to know, or I want people to select if they want to attend audience classes, email classes, or advanced classes of MailChimp. What we can do is we can add a group. So to add a group, I quite simply go Manage Contacts, Groups, and a group is just like a checklist, really. I'll click Create Groups, and there you can see as checkboxes, always radio buttons and so on. I'll just leave checkboxes for now, and let me go what kind of training do you want, for example. And it could be anything, you know, what city do you live in, what color do you like, what products do you like, whatever. And I can just add some names here, for example. Let's go audience, we'll just make it simple, audience, email marketing, and let's call this advanced. Right. I could add more, of course, and I'll click Save. I can also add multiple groups into here. Okay, so let me click Done for now. So let's go back to our preference center. So what we've done is we've hidden certain of our fields so that it won't show to people when they click to update or to go to the preferences center. I also added some groups so people can select what kind of emails they want to receive. So in other words, instead of unsubscribing from everything, they can choose just to get from certain categories, let's call them, of emails from me. And you can see you can create more groups if you really want to, as I mentioned. Okay, let's go back to our preferences center. Okay, we'll just go back to edit that to edit our preferences center that we started a little bit earlier. And now I'll just show how we can replace, click replace, and I'll just add my logo. We'll wait for the Content Studio to open. You can also choose stock photos should you wish. For now, I'll just choose my logo, click insert. Okay, and you can change the wording as you see fit. What you can see now is before we had the VIP field, the last name field, etc., etc. And because I hid them, now just the email address and first name are available. And also I can see my group here where people can check one or several of the kind of training they want. So again, when a person clicks the update profile field at the bottom of your email, they'll then see this form once we publish it. They'll then be able to change their information here should they so wish, or unsubscribe from all your emails. Okay, so to make this live, in other words, working, let's click Publish. If you want to, if you have connected or if you connect your own domain, you can use your own domain. So this is just a form that's kept on a URL, fairly basic really. Or you can just use, MailChimp's domain for this if should you so wish. Let's just call this Gary's form, whatever we want to, right? It really just does not matter. And I'll click Continue and Publish. Okay, there we go. That's done. That's how simple it is to use the Preferences Center. So a great way of, instead of someone unsubscribing from everything, they can unsubscribe from just those categories, let's call it, of emails they do or don't want to receive. But thanks for joining me. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.